Hi guys! Today I'm going to talk to you about complementary colors. Complementary colors are opposite to each other on the color wheel. So this is my color wheel, and you can see green, red and green are opposite each other. Blue and orange are opposite each other. And purple and yellow are opposite each other. These colors are all complements to each other. If you place two colors that are complements side by side, they'll intensify each other. To give you a better idea of what I'm talking about, here's a chart of all the colors separately. Now here's a chart, except in this one, each color is right next to its complement. And you can probably see that they look a lot more intense in this one. But if you mix one color with its complement, it'll dull it. If you mix any equal amounts of any two complementary colors together, you'll get brown. Say I'm mixing up color for someone's flesh, and I've added too much red. I don't have to throw out that paint and mix up a new batch. I can just mix some green into it, and if I'm careful not to add too much green, it'll cancel out the red and bring it back down to neutral so I can keep mixing. So for a quick recap, here's what that little batch of paint looked like before I added the green into it, and here's what it looks like after I added the green into it. I can correct color mistakes by the use of complementary colors, even when paint is already on my canvas, through glazing. For example, if something is too orange, I'll glaze blue over it. I mixed up this little patch of pinkish skin color to demonstrate that concept for you. Because it came out more pink than orange, I'm glazing green over it, but you can still get the gist of what I'm talking about. Okay, so the green is kind of splotchy, so I'm taking a wet brush and kind of moving it around a bit. So this is before I put the green on, and this is after I put the green on.
I'm doing this so I have to thin down my complementary color quite a lot so that it's subtle enough, because otherwise I could end up with too much of that color, meaning too much blue in this case, which would give me a whole other problem. When I'm painting someone with red or blonde hair, unless it's a dye job, I'll mix green or purple into the red or yellow paint. Green and purple are the complements of red and yellow, as I've said before, and this makes the colors more neutral. For example, for this painting of the couple in costume in Balboa Park, I painted the woman's red hair by mixing green into the red.
To give you a better idea, here are some close-ups of some red and blonde hair that I made by mixing green and purple into the red and yellow, respectively.
I really could get away with not buying brown, mixing complementary colors together, but I like to have browns on hand because it's just easier and faster than mixing all the time. When you're mixing a color's complement into it, the purpose of muting that color, you need to start small and just mix in a little at a time. Because if you go in, you take a whole glob of the other paint and just plop it in, you'll just end up with brown. And if that's not what you want, you end up using a lot of paint to get it back to the color that you really wanted.
Here's what I mean. I've just mixed a big blob of the green into the red, and you can see it's not even red anymore, it's brown.
So I hope this helps you understand how complementary colors work and how they can benefit you in your artwork. Thank you so much for watching. Subscribe for vlogs and demonstrations. Bye!